Welcome back to my channel. My name is Kayshawn, and thank you so much for clicking on this video today. You already know your girl is back with another video. Based on the title, you know exactly what I'm about to talk about. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Kayshawn with 3 E's. Y'all, really follow me on TikTok, okay? Because I've been posting a lot of content on there, but your girl can't start getting paid until she's at, like, I think 10,000 followers. And I don't have that. So make sure you tell your friends, tell your mama, tell all y'all baby daddies. I know y'all got about 3 or 4. And then tell your baby daddies to tell their baby mamas, because I'm sure they got about 5 or 6, to subscribe or to follow. Well, subscribe and follow. Okay? But y'all already know I'm dressed as a UPS worker today. It says handle with care. And that's what y'all need to do. Y'all see I got my box right here. Okay? I'm going to deliver this package to somebody later. Okay, but y'all already know. Without further ado, let's hop right into the video. Let's go. All right, y'all. So, boom. Y'all already know how I like to start my videos off. Okay, we're going to stroll down a little memory lane here, and we're going to talk about drama. Now, if you don't know who drama is, you need to be caught up on all my videos. I just posted today, and somebody was saying, like, they would be caught up on all my videos if I had them in a playlist or in order. Now, I know y'all want me to make Stassi her own playlist, but as far as my videos, my story times, I do have a story time playlist where all of the story times are in order from part 1 to part 2 and so forth, okay? So make sure you guys check out my playlist. That way you can be caught up on all my story times. So if you don't know who drama is, it's fine. It's just one of my little boos. But just watch the story times, okay? I linked up with drama. And y'all know drama has its name for a reason. And although I had no business, this is what they talk about when they say listen to your gut or take the signs from God. I knew every time I linked with drama, it was always some drama. But yet, I still linked with drama, okay? So that's what happens when you young and you turn and you lit. You don't really care about certain stuff. Like, and I'm glad that's like a phase that, well, most people grow out. Hopefully people grow out of. But let me tell you, when I linked with drama, it was after all of the baby mama drama with Eyes and his cousin and her cousin and all of that. It was after that. Now, like I said, I should have left him alone. I should have left him alone, but I did. Anyways, after we linked, I forgot if it was in story time before, like I had seen him out somewhere and we kind of started back talking a little bit. We would go through phases. Like, we would talk, it would be a lot of drama, so I fall off, and then we'll see each other at a party or out somewhere or on social media. Then we'll start talking again. Then there'll be some more drama, then I'll leave, and then I'll come back. Like, it was a lot like that, right? So this is one of the times where it was some drama, I left, and then, like, it's been some time, and he come hitting me back up, okay? He hitting me back up because it's his fucking birthday, y'all. I think I did another story time about his birthday or his cousin's birthday. I'm not sure, whatever. But it's his birthday. So, of course, he hit me up. Oh, my birthday is coming up. I haven't seen you in a long time. Like, you should come. So at first, I'm thinking, like, I'm not coming because I already have drama with, like, your baby mama. Even though me and his baby mama wasn't, like, really beefed out, because once that stuff happened with her cousin and all of that, like, she, you know, the heat was off of me. But it's, like, there's already situations with your baby mama, with her cousin. It's just, like, every time I get around you and all your people, it's just, it's not even, like, his family, but, like, the friends and baby mama, all it just be too much. So I don't like to do stuff with him when it's, like, a big thing. Like, if it's his birthday, I don't want to be around all your people because you got too much shit going on. And you never know who messing with who. And then all your homeboys, you know, you from a certain hood. And even though drama is cool, a lot of his homeboys do too much sometimes. And I don't want to be around that, right? So I told him, I'm like, well, I'm probably not going to come to your party, but, you know, maybe we could do something together, like, separately. Like, you know, we'll go out another time or whatever, because you got too much drama, right? Okay, so he act like he know me. He like, oh, I already knew you were going to say something like that. That's why I wanted you to come out. So, basically, let's say his birthday was a Wednesday. It was somewhere in the middle of the week. He was saying the weekend before we could do something, and then the weekend after is when he's having his party, like, with his whole hood. So he's like, oh, yeah, that's why I want you to come out this weekend, which would have been the weekend before his birthday. He's like, I want you to come out with me and a couple friends this weekend because my party is not till next weekend. So, you know, I'm thinking like, oh, okay, well, then that might be cool because I don't mind celebrating your birthday. It's just you be doing too much. So he like, yeah, I'm gonna grab a couple of my homeboys. You get a couple of your people, whatever, and we're gonna go out, right? So I'm like, okay, bet. So mind y'all, at this time, so I don't feel like going back to that story time, and I don't know what I called the cousin. I think I titled it something along the lines like his cousin didn't like me at all or something around that time. Remember when I was saying like it was a his friend that just got out of jail was there and like he was drunk and doing too much. I don't know what I called him. I probably just called him drunky. I'm not sure, but we're gonna bring him into the story time. So mind y'all, if y'all remember the cousin that just got out of jail, if you don't remember the story time, it's fine. Drama had this cousin, friend, whatever he was supposed to be to him, that had just got out of jail like that day or the day before, and he was super drunk at a party and he was doing too much and he was like too touchy-feely with the girls and he just was drunk and doing a lot, right? So I didn't care for him because although he didn't do nothing necessarily to me, you know, when you see somebody character, you like, I'm just straight on that, right? So I don't think I gave him a name, or if I did, I don't remember. We're just gonna call him Red, right? We're gonna call him Red. So I'm asking him who coming out, because like I said, at this point, I've been around drama a lot. So I know not all his friends, because he got a whole hood, but I know the ones that I like and the ones that I really don't like, right? So I'm asking him who's going to come. So he like, it's just going to be me. It's me, Faith.
It's me. I'm Slim. Faith, Tradie, Dog.
Say no. He like, it's going to be me, such and such, such and such, and Red. So it's like, everybody else was cool, but when he said Red, I haven't seen Red in like the longest, okay, at this point. But the last memory, you know, they say first impressions are everything. I haven't hung out with him or nothing since then. But the last thing I remember about Red is that he get drunk and he do too much. So in my opinion, I'm like, I don't know about him. I'm like, Red, is that the one from the party that was doing X, Y, and Z? So he like, yeah. I'm like, I don't know if I want to be around him because he was doing too much and he was too touchy-feely and he was just doing a lot. He was disrespectful. And he like, nah, you know, my nigga Red not like that. That was just his first day out. He, you know, he was locked up for so long. So he haven't got drunk in a long time, so he just got too drunk and was doing too much. Like, he not like that at all. So, you know, I'm in the back of my head thinking like, okay, well, like, fine, because I did try to give him the benefit of the doubt. Like, he did just get out of prison. I think he was in for a long time too or whatever. So I'm like, maybe he did, because this is welcome home party, maybe he did just have too much alcohol. And you know, when you fresh out, you know, just a lot going on. So I'm like, okay, I'm like, drama, I'ma trust you. If you say, you know, he only act like that one time and he don't do that no more, fine. We're gonna go with that, right? Okay, cool. So I was like, all right, then that's fine. So, you know, I get me and my homegirls and stuff like that. So the thing is, we was gonna meet up at drama house. We didn't have like a legit destination, or if they did, he didn't ever tell me where we was going. He just told us to pull up. So I'm like, okay, y'all, we probably gonna go to a club, a bar, go to the block. Like, we probably just gonna do something, we're gonna hang out. So, you know, my homegirls, we all down, we cool, we fine with it. Okay, so, all right, so y'all already know, I pick everybody up. We was going pregame, but it's like drama was rushing me to get to his house. And I'm thinking like, boy, don't rush me. Like, why are you rushing me to come over? Like, you ain't never rushed me before, right? So anyway, so he kept calling me like, where you at, where you at? Mind you, I'm like, I'm picking up the last girl. Like, I'm coming. You the one want to have four or five niggas there, so I got to get four or five girls. Like, well, don't rush me, right? So cool, I'm like, boy, I would be there in about 10, 15 minutes, like, hold on. So he like, you don't need a pregame. Like, y'all don't gotta stop and get no liquor. We already got liquor here. I'm like, okay, like, I'm coming. So whatever, okay, cool. I pick up the last girl, we go straight there. Like, we did want to get a bottle and stuff, but I wasn't really tripping because everything gonna be on you anyways. Even though it's your birthday, you don't want me to stop, then okay. So whatever, we get there. So we say hey to everybody, you know, so a couple guys there, whatever. It's drama happy to see me. We hugging and stuff, everybody kind of introducing themselves. So mind y'all, okay, let's say it was me. It was four of us total for the girls, including me. So I only picked up three girls. I know I said four or five, but I was just exaggerating. It was only four of us. Now, it was like six of them, including drama. So it was six guys and stuff. So I'm like, okay, that's cool. Because like I always say, we don't always have to talk to, it doesn't have to be an even amount of number, because nobody has to talk to anybody if they don't want to, right? So we get there. So drama like, come on, we need to go pick up somebody. So I'm thinking like, oh my God, who are you going to go pick up? Like, what's going on? Like, why are you doing all of that, right? So I'm like, okay, well, why we can't just stay here? I'm like, everybody got to go pick up somebody because I didn't want to be driving everywhere. So, you know, he like, well, you already know you ain't got to drive. Y'all can just hop in my truck. Y'all know Drama got a truck. If y'all don't know, now you know. So we do always pile in his car. So I'm like, okay, cool. Normally that's what I do anyways. I park my car there because, you know, when you people guys, hood niggas, they want to ride around everywhere, go to that block, up the street, down the street, around the corner, in the sky, underground. They want to do too much. So I don't like following behind them. Even though I really like to have my car, it's too much to keep up with them because they got a million and one destinations, right? So I'm like, okay, homegirls, we're going to ride with Drama. Mind you, two of my homegirls, no Drama. The other homegirl was a homegirl of my homegirl, but I know her, but she more so hang out with her or whatever. So they like, cool, like we're going to get in the car. We already know we load up in Drama trucks. So mind y'all, it's four of us. So, you know, I hop in the front seat, they get in the truck, and I see more people is coming over, like more of the guys is coming. So, you know, I'm looking at Drama like, what is everybody doing? Like, all of us can't fit in this car. Like, if it's four girls and six guys, including Drama, how is 10 of us about to pile up in this car? Even if it's a third seat, like 3, 6, 7, 8 is about as many people as we can take, okay? Like, why is you trying to, what's going on? So he like, oh, we can't fit. He looking back to see like, oh, we can't, everybody can't fit in there. And I'm looking at him irritated because I'm like, Drama, why would you think 10 of us can fit in this truck, like, comfortably? Like, no, everybody can't fit in here. So, you know, he like, yeah, no, it is a lot of us. Like, no, okay, somebody got to take their car, too. And I'm thinking, like, didn't you say you was going to go pick somebody up? Like, did you think 11 people was about to fit in this car? Because now I'm starting to get irritated. Cause you know when somebody kind of do something stupid, you be looking at them like, don't piss me off, Drama. Because I'm like, oh, you normally ain't this dumb. Why would you ever in your right mind think 11 people, just because you got a fucking truck, why would you think 11 people is about to pile up in this car? Like, we're not doing that. So I'm like, no, you're doing too much. Like, 11 people can't fit. So Red ass, oh my God. So he want to come and he like, man, bro, don't listen. I'm sure we could fit. We probably all can fit in here. So I look back and I'm like, no, y'all can't. I know y'all probably think like, this not even your car. I don't care. You told me and my homegirls to get in this car. So I'm like, Drama, no, they cannot. Like, y'all not about to be squishing my homegirls. Like, y'all not going to have them piled on top of each other because y'all want to fit fucking 10 people in this car and we about to go pick somebody up. Is it me? Now, I'm all for piling up in a little car, but normally it'd be like one or two people over. It don't be four, five, or six. Like, come on now. Normally, if you got a backseat that fit three and it's four of y'all in the backseat, okay, cool. But you're trying to fit 11 fucking people. What are you doing? So I'm like, no, y'all not about to have them squished and do all of that. So one of the whole boys was like, yeah, we definitely wasn't about to pile in this car. Like, I drive my car so some people can ride with me. So, I'm like, okay, like, you know, cool, because what y'all think, like, y'all not about to have my girls squished back there, like, y'all doing too much, right? Because basically, all three of my girls, of course, was in the middle row, so only the back row would have been available, which only fit, like, three people. So, they end up driving, and Red is like, well, whatever, yeah, you can go drive your own car, but I'm still getting this truck, because whoever we pick up is going to get in this truck, too. So I'm thinking like, okay, like, I don't know who he's talking to, but I'm just like, I ain't saying nothing to that because I'm thinking like, okay, go ahead and get in the car then. Like, shit, we don't care where you ride at as long as everybody not squished. So mind you, like I said, this is where I should have went on and hop out the truck and got in my car and left. Because then I told y'all, my three girls are sitting in the middle row. Like, you know, it's three rows, so they sitting in the middle row. So he's like waiting. I'm looking at him like, are you getting in here? Like, what are you doing? And he like, can two of y'all get in the back seat? That way I could sit in the middle. And I'm looking like, no, why you can't get in the back seat? This is my thing, y'all. I think I already had a bad taste about Red, and it's just the way he talked to people. Like, you know the saying, it's not about what you say, it's how you say it. He just got this real aggressive demeanor, and I don't like that. And I'm like, Drama, like, I already kind of told you how I feel about him, so you should have made sure he was extra, like, on his best behavior when I'm coming around. Not saying that people got to change the way they is, but if you want me around somebody and I told you how I feel about them, then you need to make sure that they good. Like, I don't like disrespectful ass niggas. I don't like people who talk to people crazy. We're not doing that. So I was like, y'all ain't gonna get in the backseat. Why you can't get in the backseat? So, you know, Drama, like, once I said something, Drama, like, bro, just hop in the backseat. Like, don't do all of that. And he, like, I'm just saying, man, I'm too big. I'm too big to be all the way back here and all of this. Like, nigga, no, you not. Like, no, you not. Like, even if you asked nicely, maybe my girls could have moved, but you don't just tell them to get in the back. Like, who the fuck is you talking to? You get your ass in the back. So he ended up going back there or whatever, like huffing and puffing, like he got attitude because he got to go all the way to the third seat. Boy, get in your car then. Like, drama told the girls to ride with him. You could have rode with somebody else. So he get all the way in the back. So he like, so you know, the whole time he talking shit back there, when my homegirl like closed the seat, you know, to sit back down, he like, okay, don't close it so hard. Like, just chill out. Like, bro, what you trying to crush my motherfucking knees? So I'm like, my homegirl like, well, I didn't mean to do it hard. Like, it just clamped back, you know, it just snapped back. So she like, I didn't even do that. So I looked at drama. I'm like, drama, for real? I'm telling you, like, he already knew what I was talking about. Because I'm like, I already told you about him. Like, come on now. So he like, no, he going to be good. He like, man, Red, chill the fuck out. Make sure you chill out tonight. Like, we not trying to be on none of that weird ass shit. And I'm like, because, yeah, don't be yelling at my homegirl. So he tried to, like, while I was looking back saying that, he tried to, like, you know, when you behind somebody and you rub their shoulders. He like, homegirl, what did I yell at you? I was just saying, like, try to touch her shoulders. And she like, nah, it's cool. Like, it's all good. So I'm just like, yeah, like, you know, make sure you chill tonight, right? Cool. We all in the car, we driving. You know, I hear him back there on the phone or whatever, talking to whoever. I'm acting drama like, yeah, where we gonna go? So he like, oh, we was gonna stop at my cousin bar. His cousin owned this little bar, so he wanted to stop by there. So the boys that rode in the other car, they was gonna go straight there, because I guess we was just picking somebody up. So they like, we gonna meet y'all at the bar, you know, just pull up when y'all done. So they went another way to go ahead and go to the bar. We gonna go pick somebody up. Mind you, I never asked who we was picking up, because, you know, that's not my business. I just figured it was like another one of his homeboys or something. You know, I'm not really thinking of it. So we driving for a little bit and we turned down one block, and drama was like asking Red like, which one is the house? So he like, oh, keep going. Like, you know, he telling them keep going. Then he like, stop right here. So, you know, drama pull up in front of the house. So, you know, I'm just looking like, okay, who about to come out? What's going on? I see a girl come out. So I'm thinking like, oh, okay, whatever. Maybe this is like his girlfriend or somebody he's talking to that we're picking up. Like, okay. I see her come out, and you know how, like, it's dark, but, like, if, like, let's say you're coming out the front door and, like, your living room light is on, you can see the silhouette of people coming out, but you can't really see their faces. So I see one person come out, then I see two people coming out, then I see three people coming out. So I'm like, what the fuck? Like, where is they going? I'm looking in the driveway. I don't see no fucking cars, because I'm like, is they about to drive? Mind you, the truck that we're in of dramas is three rows, right? But that back seat, that third row, it's not like a big one. Like, that way that back seat is, it's like maybe three kids can fit in that third row, but really only two adults. And then you got the middle row, right? The middle row is already packed up with my homegirls. If we feeling friendly enough, we might could squeeze one more, but that would be pushing it. But it would be pushing it to put another person in the middle, and it would be pushing it to put two people in the back. But that's still three girls, right? I'm seeing people come out, and then the fourth girl comes out, and she shuts the door. So I'm looking like, where is these four girls going? But it is cars, like, you know, parked on the street. So I'm thinking, I'm like, let me not say nothing, because maybe they about to walk to their car. Like, maybe, like, I'm not sure. So the first girl that walked off the porch, I see her walking up to the backseat door, and I looked at drama, and I'm like, drama, where is they going? Like, all four of them cannot fit in here. Like, what are you doing? This nigga drama like, bro, I thought you said we was only picking up your little friend. Like, what's going on with all three of them? Like, what's up? So he like, I don't know. Let me see. Like, let me out, whatever. So my homegirl, she scoot over to the middle to let the one seat down, and he's getting out. So, you know, I do got the window was already cracked or whatever, and I'm not about to roll it up because they right here. So he's like, oh, like, you, I didn't know you had your other homegirls. And the girl is like, what are you talking about, Red? I said I was with some friends. And he like, oh, all of them need a ride. So you could tell, like, Red was on some bullshit, because she was like, I told you, like, we want to hang out with y'all. Like, what are you talking about? Do we all need a ride? You said you was coming to pick us up. He like, oh, I didn't know you had, it was four, y'all. She like, how you didn't know? Like, you FaceTime me and everybody was in the background. Like, what are you talking about? You could tell she was just getting irritated with him. Like, you on some bullshit. Oh, at the, while they out there talking, somebody had ended up calling drama. And I don't know if, like, I don't know what it is. It was something wrong at the door that he was saying, like, put, what's the name on the phone? Like, put one of the securities on the phone, da da da. So I don't know if they had trouble getting in or something with the booth or the section. I don't really know. He on the phone talking to whoever about whatever. They're outside talking. At the same time, Red got the door open, so you know the light on in the car. So he's talking. He like, nah, babe, I think we all can fit. Like, we all can fit. So I'm like, no, I'm tapping drama. Like, hurry up with that phone call, because no offense, and I'm a girl's girl. Don't get me wrong at all. Like, it's nothing against them. It's just that we all not to Like, if I wouldn't pile up in this car with his friends, the other niggas that I know, why would I pile up in a car with four other girls that I don't know? Like, it's not even about not being a girl's girl. It's like, we not all about to pile up in this car, baby. Like, we're not doing that. So, I tap drama because I'm like, you're not about to make my friends uncomfortable. You invited me out. This is your birthday weekend. First of all, I don't even know how all of this turned into all of your friends when I specifically told you I didn't care to hang out with all your people. You try to act like it's only be a couple of y'all, which I guess six really is not like a lot, because that is like a few people, especially for drama, because normally drama bring the whole block out. So I guess this was a smaller crowd. But I'm like, you need to get off the phone. They not about to squish my friends. Like, what's going on? So he's trying to tell them, he like, homegirls, maybe y'all three can get in the back and then we all can pile in the middle. So I turned around, I'm like, no, don't squish my friends in the back. Like, it's no way to pile in. Like, all of y'all cannot pile up in here. Like, what are you talking about? How are y'all gonna fit? It's like, no, that back seat is small as hell. You're not about to squish my friends back there. So all of y'all, so five of y'all can pile up in the middle. It just was not gonna work. My friends is thick too. Like, they can't fit back there. It wasn't working that way, right? Especially, we not about to squeeze back there so y'all can have some other girls around there. So, you know, the girls, so at that point, the rest of the girls started walking up or whatever. So they like, what's all of this? Like, I know they was gonna have some other girls and stuff. So I'm sitting here looking at drama like, baby, you about to have to pull off in a minute, because I ain't trying to make it a thing between us and them girls, because we don't know them and we don't need to be in no drama, because they see us, we see them. It's just, I'm not here for none of that. So drama, when he got off the phone, he like, Red, what the fuck is you doing? You said only one girl was coming. I don't know about all the rest of these bitches. I don't know why drama started to get disrespectful, I'm not gonna lie. But I don't know if he just was agitated already, because drama normally not like a disrespectful person for real. But I don't know what he had going on that day. But anyways, he like, you said it was only one girl. I don't know what's going on with the rest of these bitches. Like, what's going on here? So, you know, the girls, of course, as they should, I would react the same. They like, bitches, don't fucking call us no bitches. Like, what the fuck is going on? And they said the girl name, say her name was like Stacy or something. They like, Stacy, because who are these niggas? What's going on? Like, they got girls. Like, I'm not about to go. So drama is like, Red, come on, bro. You said we're only picking up one girl. Only one girl is getting in this car. So either they coming or they not. Like, so the girl, like, Stacy, who was talking to Red, she like, nah, he too fucking disrespectful. Like, I'm good. Like, I'm straight. Red, like, no. So Red, like, no, bro, like, come on. Like, you get in this car. Like, your homegirls just can't come. Like, so just get in the car. So I'm thinking, like, not you think this girl gonna leave her homegirls at the house. Like, most likely this is probably her house. Why would you tell the homegirl to leave the rest of her friends and get in the car with some girls and think she's just gonna do that? So Stacy is like, I'm not about to just get in the car. Like, no. This nigga Red, I told y'all, I told y'all in the other video about him. He's weird. I don't like him. He's too aggressive. He gives definitely DV in relationships. Of course, I don't know that, so I'm not gonna, you know, put that on him, but that's what he give. So he telling her, like, man, come on, but you could tell. Maybe that's why drama felt comfortable calling them bitches and stuff, because they allow that. Because you could tell, because he was calling her all types of names, and she was just sitting there looking like she used to that. So she like, he like, man, bitch, come on. Like, why you even playing? Like, oh, yo, for you don't need all of them. You supposed to be here for me. Like, why do you need all them girls and you supposed to be kicking it with me? Like, man, come on. Get the fuck in the car. Like, trying to push her in the back. Because mind you, my homegirls, you know when you lift the seat up, so you like kind of leaning over. Like, my one homegirl kind of sitting on my other homegirl lap because she got this seat down, right, so they can get in the back. So he's like trying to push her in the car. So I'm looking like, drama, tell him he can't be pushing on her though. Like, I don't know these girls, but you can't push her and make her get in the car. Like, she said she's not going without her homegirls. So he's trying to like push her, tell her to get in. She like, no, Red. So her friends is like, Stacy, what you gonna do? Like, you leaving us? Like, how you just gonna leave us at your house? Like, you said we was hanging with them. Like, what the fuck is going on? So Red is getting mad at Stacy. He like, man, bitch, you doing too fucking much. Like, get in the car. He like, you know what? Okay, he gonna walk up to the passenger door where I'm fucking at, and he gonna say, Kate, how about you and your homegirls get all the way in the third row, and then Stacy and her homegirls can get in the middle row. Bitch, are you dumb? Are you stupid? I said, I'm not going anywhere. Like, because he felt, because he's bigger than us, that he'll sit in the front seat and then we can all be fucking squished in the back. I told y'all, the back seat barely fit three people, let alone four. I'm not lapping up. I'm not doing all of that. I'm not doing it. So I'm like, before I can even get out of drama, like, No, Kay not going nowhere. Like, bro, you said we was picking up one girl. Either we picking her up or we're leaving. Like, they're waiting for us at the bar. I don't know what all this other goofy shit you on, but we're not doing all of that. So I'm like, yeah, you know, I'm just sitting there because I'm like, you know, once drama starts saying stuff to him, you know, I always be quiet because, you know, let the guys handle their shit and that's his friend. So he's like, Red is like, oh my God, Kay, you could have just went to the back. No, the fuck I couldn't. So drama like, no, the fuck you can't, nigga. I'm about to pull off. Like, what are you doing? So he go back to Stacey and he like, Stacey, just get in the back seat with me. Like, tell them bitches bye. So I'm like, Stacey, you a damn fool. If you, what? So Stacey is like, no, Red, I'm not going nowhere with you. Like, if my homegirls can't come, then I'm not going. So he get mad. Like, he like, man, bro, you fucking wasting my time, bro. Like, bitch, don't fucking call me no more. Like, he's cussing her out or whatever. I'm thinking, like, how you mad at her? You knew once you seen everybody in this truck that it's no way that all them girls was gonna fit. But whatever. So he like, just get in the car. He's yelling at her. She like, no, her friends is seeing stuff. He like, all right, man, whatever, bitch, bye. He get back in the back seat and we pull off. So I'm thinking, like, I'm looking at my homegirls like, the fuck? So I'm like, drama, I'm about to go home. I'm looking, he like, no, I'm sorry. Like, he said he just wanted to pick up his girl. I thought it was going to be a quick little pickup so he can have somebody to be with. That way he ain't got to get on our nerves tonight. And that's it. Like, I thought it was going to be simple. He like, man, Red, I should have known. Ain't shit simple with your ass. Like, and he like, no, bro, I know she had all them girls and stuff. I thought it was just her and maybe one other person and da-da-da, all of this. And I'm just looking like, yeah, you know what? This too fucking much. So he like, hold up, that we went to the corner, right? He like, hold on, before you pull off, he on the phone. He got the phone up to his ear. He like, hold on, let me call somebody else to see if they want to come. So drama like, bro, no, I'm about to go to the bar. Like, bro, why do you need somebody to be with you so bad? Meet somebody at the bar or something. Like, you want drama to ride around town, picking up all your little girls that you want to talk to because you want them to come out tonight. You're doing too much. So I'm looking at drama like, can we just go to the bar? I thought we was kicking it. I thought this night was more so about me kicking it with you for your birthday. Like, this was supposed to be our thing. Like, even though I didn't plan this night for him, but if you wanted me to celebrate your birthday with you, specifically me, and I asked you to do something separately from all your friends, then yeah, it is more so about me and you. So I'm telling drama, like, I thought this was supposed to be about us hanging out. Like, I was gonna get you a shot at the bar. Like, we was gonna turn up. Like, what's going on? And he's like, no, we is. Like, that's why I'm about to go straight to the bar. And Red like, Kay, y'all still gonna hang out? Like, what you mad? Like, you don't want me to have no girl tonight? And I look back and I say, and why the fuck would I be mad about you having a girl tonight? Because why would I care? You need to have your own car then, Red, because I haven't seen you in a long time. And at this point, you still ain't got no car? You should have rode with somebody. You should have did something else. You should have had that girl get dropped off. Y'all should have did all this shit before I got here is what I'm saying. Like, it's not about you tonight, Red. It's not about you. That night that it was your welcome home party or whatever, that night was about you. It's not your birthday. It's not none of that. It's not about you tonight. As I keep stating, I already don't care for him like that because you was doing too much at the last thing. But like I said, you wasn't doing it to me, so I try to pass by it. I try to bypass it, right? So I'm just thinking like, but you need to stop saying shit to me or whatever. Anyways, we drive off whatever. We end up pulling up to the bar. His people are already there, a couple people that was at the house. So we go there, and he should have did. The thing is, Red should have did what they did. Like, it was a couple more guys, like maybe like two or three guys that came, and they came. They had the girls meet them up there at the booth, like at the bar, club, lounge, whatever y'all want to call it. You should have did that. You should have told the girls to pull up to the booth, not you trying to go pick up everybody, and you ain't got no fucking car. So we go there. We at the booth or whatever. So we turned up, we having a good time, whatever. The guys that was there, majority of them, besides like maybe three guys, I knew. Like, those was his main guys that he hung around. Every time I was there, they was cool as fuck. Like, they was cool, right? While we started to turn up, this nigga Red is complaining the whole time. He's talking about how it ain't no bitches in there. Mind you, it definitely was. Like, let's be real. You think that it's just all niggas up there. Half of the time you go to these bars and clubs and stuff, they let more women in than they do males. So, it was definitely women everywhere, okay? They just probably wasn't interested in your little raggedy ass, okay? But he talking about how it ain't no girls there. embarrassed. Like, he's talking to drama. Mind y'all, since I'm celebrating his birthday today with him, I'm giving him his little birthday dances. I'm trying to turn up with drama. Red trying to talk to him. So picture drama sitting down. And mind you, we had like a little hole in the wall, right? And mind you, this is cousin stuff too. So I'm standing like on that, picture my feet like on the seat. Like if he, this drama sitting like me, I got my feet on the seat right here and I'm all like shaking the JCs in his face stuff. Picture me trying to dance and be all in his face and be freaky and funny because we drinking and we turn, and somebody whispering in your ear. Like Red is all whispering in his ear. So low key, I'm shaking the JCs and Red face too, because drama right here, he got his little cup, and you know when people hold the cup in their mouth like by the rim. So he got his cup in his mouth or whatever, and you know he patty caking, he turned it up with me and Red right here. So I'm shaking ass all right here. So Red face is like right here. So I'm looking, and because you know I get a little nasty, you know, whatever. You know when you be like, like say this is a drama face, like how you be like doing this with your butt to somebody's face, like, you know, like pushing it in their face and bringing it back out. I was doing that. So I didn't notice for real Red, like, because mind you, when I'm looking back on this side. So all I really see is drama or whatever. So, you know, I was doing it in the circle at first, having fun. So then I started doing like this, like to my butt in his face. I know y'all, I know it's nasty, we freaky, but that's okay, we drunk. So I'm doing that, y'all. I feel two faces in the JCs. So I'm turning around and mind y'all, it's Red's side profile, because I don't want y'all to think like they both just was sitting there having their face ready. But because he keep trying to talk to drama, when I threw it back that first time, it like kind of hit him too. So you know, I turned around, I'm like, what is you doing? I'm like, can you move? And I did say it with an attitude, because my thing is, whether it's freaky, nasty, whatever, all of that, I'm only like that with that one person I'm talking to. Like, this ain't for everybody, okay? Baby, I'm not for everybody. I'm not, like, we not gonna play that game. I see there's two niggas here. I'm throwing ass. You all in it. This is supposed to just be for drama. You get what I'm saying? Like, you need to move back. And then my thing is, if you see your nigga getting a dance, if you see him doing whatever, as his friend, fall back anyways. You shouldn't even be trying to have a conversation and he's getting a birthday dance and he's taking shots. So, you know, it's like as soon as it happened so quick. So when I went back and felt his face and I turned around, I looked back and drama was already like, bro, gone. He still had the cup in his hand, because he's holding on to my waist with this one. Cup in his hand. And he's like, man, gone. Because he's still biting the rim of the cup. So he's like, man, gone, whatever. So he removed his hand. He grabbed the cup. He's like, can you back up? So he like, man, bro, I'll just try to tell you something. You doing all that because you got a little ass in your face? Like, come on now. So drama is like, bro, just back up. Like, if I'm getting a dance, why you all up on me? And they saying whatever they saying back there. Because mind you, now I'm standing up on, like, the little booth part. But, like, I'm standing all the way up. I'm not bent over, like, dancing. I'm standing up. So it's like I'm up here and they down there talking. So I'm just looking like whatever. They saying whatever. So Red, like, did a man. And he kind of, like, got up and went towards the end of the booth. I get down. I'm just like, what the fuck? Like, he like, man, I don't know. He on some other stuff. So he didn't want to say too much because he already knew I was going to be like, I told you so, because I told you I don't with that the Red. I get a bad vibe from him. I don't like that. But then you try to vouch for him. You want to act like, oh, he all right. He good. No, he not good. He doing too much. Just like I knew he would. That's why they want him to come out. So, you know, I'm like, yeah, I'm dancing. Why do I feel two faces on the JCs? Like, what's going on? So, you know, I'm looking at my homegirl. So we just took that time to all take a shot. So we taking a shot or whatever, and his one homeboy that always be around, like, he cool as fuck. He like, let me do a cheers to my day one, A1, Ace Boo Cool, shit, Home Skillet Biscuit, nigga from day one, so nah. He like, let me do a little cheers or whatever. So, of course, since we're doing a whole little toast for his birthday, Red want to come back over, get a cup, and do a cheer. So we all doing the cheers, and we take the shots. So it's lit. So it's like when he came back over to do a shot, you know, he get the, like, he been drinking a little bit more at this point. So he get to talking, like, I don't know if he thought he was being funny or what, but he gonna look over at me. He like, you know what, Kat? I do not like you. So, you know, I'm like, you know what, Red? I don't give a fuck. Like, so he try to laugh and say it, though. And you know what they be saying? Like, when people try to make jokes, they really be telling the truth, though. So he try to laugh like, Kat, I do not like you. And I'm like, Red, I do not give a fuck. Like, well, I don't care. So he like, yeah, you ain't got to care about it. I just, you know, I'm a real ass nigga, so I want to let you know that I don't fuck with you. And I'm like, and I'm a real ass bitch, and I want to let you know I could give two fucks who you fuck with. I don't care. So, like, what? So my friend friends is just like, can you back up? Because mind you, he's big, a little bigger than me, so he's like leaned down talking to me. So my friend is like, back up. And it's like, she just went like this. And you know, when somebody try to dodge, you know, you touching them, but she wasn't even going to touch him. So he kind of moved back. So my friend like, I wasn't about to touch you, nigga, calm down. So drama, he was already talking to like somebody else, like whatever, one of the other homeboys. So when he kind of seen that, he walked over there like, what's going on? I'm like, your homeboy feel the need to let me know that he don't like me. And drama like, nigga, what the fuck? How you ain't gonna like her? You don't even know her. I'm like, exactly. Like, I met him that one time, a whole long time ago. I'm about to say a while ago. A long time ago. And me and you barely even had words because you was too fucking drunk out of your mind doing other shit to other people. So we barely even had words and stuff. So how you gonna say you don't like me? Even if you don't like me, I don't give a fuck, but you don't even know me. So drama is saying that. He's like, man, no, you know, being in prison, I'm a good judge of character. You and being outside in the real world, I'm a good judge of character as well. And I'm judging your character right now. And it ain't that good. Why you talking about me? You know, you are drunk. So he like, nah, bro, I'm telling you, I don't know nobody, male or female, that would cock block another nigga. So talking about me. So I said, when did I cock block you? Like, what are you talking about? He like, I'm just not understanding. He started doing one of these. Now, mind you, it wasn't in my face, but it's just like, if you're talking to me and you're doing this, it don't got to be right in my face or pointing at me. Why are you doing this anyways? He like, bro, because all you had to do was get in the back seat and everybody could have got in the car. So I'm thinking like, what? Mind you, me and drama talking at the same time because drama saying stuff to him. But like I told y'all before, normally when they say stuff to each other, I normally leave it alone. But I'm drinking and I feel like you're talking to me. So I'm going to get the shit off my chest, whatever I feel like I need to say. Like, I ain't cock block you. First of all, four bitches wasn't fitting in no car at all. That's it. Anyways, so he like, bitches, or you want to call them bitches, I bet you want to say that shit to their face, just like a messy ass nigga. Because granted, I wasn't calling them bitches to be disrespectful, it's just that I'm drunk, I'm just saying it, like, but you tell me I wouldn't say it to their face, so of course, now I gotta be like, and I will, like, it ain't no drama with them, but like, don't tell me I wouldn't call them bitches to their face, because I don't give a fuck. So I'm like, yes, I will. He like, I call them up here right now, just like a lame ass nigga. Now you want to call some bitches on me? For what? Because you don't fuck with me? Because you don't like me? So I'm like, call them. So he like, I call them up here right now. I bet you won't say it to their face. So drama like, yeah, Red, you about to have to go in a minute because like, you said you was going to be on your best behavior. You tripping. And you know, of course, because he drunk, like, I think if he don't drink, maybe he'll be okay. But him drinking just takes him to another level. So I'm like, call them, like, you know, when you drunk and you keep repeating the same stuff, because I'm trying to calm him down, but meanwhile, now I'm lit. I'm like, call them, because you're not going to ever tell me I wouldn't say something to somebody's face because you just probably don't like me and you want some girls to fight me, whatever the case is. I'm like, call them. I'm not worried about shit. So drama like, nah, sit down. You're not about to do nothing, and he ain't about to call nobody. Like, Red, go on with that. So I'm like, yeah, you coming over here starting shit with me, talking about how you don't like me. You just probably mad because you wanted all four of them girls to fit in the car. You mad that the girl wouldn't leave her friend. So now you don't got no girl to be on, even though it's girls in the club. All you got to do is try to talk to them. But if you don't want to talk to them, fine, but now you mad. And if anything, you really should be mad at drama because I could have drove my own car, like I said. Drama is the one that want me to ride with him because I always ride with him anyways. And drama is the one who told me to bring all my homegirls, even though this wasn't all of them, it was only four of us total. But he the one that told me to bring people, and he the one said that we was riding with him. So if you knew it was multiple people that you wanted drama to pick up, you should have talked to your homeboy and said, hey, let the girls drive their own car because I want you to pick up these other girls. More than likely, drama probably just ain't want to pick up all them girls anyways. I don't know, but that ain't got nothing to do with me, right? So you know, he upset or whatever, so he caught himself getting booked with drama. Typical shit. Like, this nigga, he always a problem. So mind you, of course, I don't know everybody relation, of course, I don't know who really know Red and who don't, I don't know, but I do know that drama day one dude, like, you know, he don't play about drama, just like drama don't play about him. So when he's getting booked with drama, I'ma just call him day one. His day one friend, he like, Red, he telling him to calm down. He like, it's his nigga birthday. Like, don't do all of that. Now, day one is the only one that got really, like, common sense. Like, even though drama, he one of them hood dudes that's like, he just hood because he grew up in this shit, but he's still smart. He think. He got a good head on his shoulder. Like, he don't do all that wild, rah-rah stuff. He don't do all of that. So he looking at, he's like, you need to calm down. Like, I'm not on none of that. He don't like no extra. That's why I like him for drama. Like, he keep the peace. Like, he don't like a lot of, because he into a lot of shit, so he don't like when there's a lot of tension on them, when there's a lot of chaos. He don't like none of that. So he's telling Red, like, you gotta calm down because you bringing a lot of tension to the booth. You doing too much. Like, don't do all of that. So, of course, Red being Red, he telling niggas, don't tell me what the fuck to do. Who the fuck is you to tell me to calm down all of this? So, you know, day one is, I be about to say that real name. So, you know, day one is looking at drama like, you better get your mans. You know how I am. So Red butt in like, and nigga, and that nigga know how I am too. So I'm like, drama, I blame you. You the messy one. Because clearly everybody here, I think that's why I feel like none of them really messed with Red or didn't know him for real, because nobody was really talking to Red. Like, all his day ones and his homeboys, they was all talking to each other. They weren't really talking to Red, which is probably why when drama is getting a dance, you steady trying to talk to him because nobody else is talking to you. I don't know if they don't like him, don't care for him, or if he just one of them niggas that do too much, so they keep their distance. I don't know, which is probably why you wanted you to have a girl here, because you knew majority of the niggas here did not fuck with you. That's probably what it was. But I'm looking at drama too, like, you're messy. Like, it seems like nobody wanted him here. Why would you invite this nigga out? And I understand if he your homeboy, but you should know who to mix with who. You should know that, like, if this nigga always do too much, hang out with him on your own time by yourself. Don't bring him around everybody, right? So they kind of getting into it a little bit, day one and Red. So drama is like trying to separate them, break that up. He calls one of the securities that's like his cousin or his homeboy or whatever. He like, come over here, like, we just gonna take Red out. And he was telling me, like, I'ma just take Red home, because we wasn't far from where drama lived at, because like I said, we had, like, you know, we weren't far. So he was telling me, like, I'ma have to probably just take Red home or whatever and come back. So I'm like, that's fine, because his day one and the other two homeboys, like, I really know them. Like, I'm cool with being here with them. They know me, I know them, I trust them. I'm telling him, like, yeah, like, take that nigga home, get him out of here. So day one is just like, yeah, bro, like, the girls is good, I got them, like, yeah, go ahead and get him out. So drama is trying to push Red, like, towards the door with the help of the security. The security was just walking with them, because at first Red was going, so the security had no reason to, like, grab him up or hold him or whatever, because he was walking. So he's steady talking shit. Day one just looking, and mind you, you gotta kind of come out the booth like this and, like, go that way. So he's coming down, he's talking or whatever. Mind you, we literally have a bottle right here with ice and all of that. This goofy Red, as he's walking past, he's gonna pick up the bottle and do like this and act like he was gonna hit day one with it. He didn't throw it or nothing, he just did it. But of course, if you flinch at somebody, they don't know your next move. It's like them niggas hopped on him so quick, and by default, they hopped on drama. Because it's like, you had to, where you was at in the booth, some of the niggas was like, it's a table. Let's say Red is right here. It's a table where he grabbed the bottle, and day one and the homeboys is over here. So it's like they just lunged over. So they stepped all over the table, knocked down the Red Bulls and ice buckets and stuff. It's like him and his homeboys reacted. So like they just jumped over there. So of course, it's this big chaos. This big thing, because Red don't know how to just be cool, be on his best behavior, or because drama don't know how to not bring this nigga out knowing he don't know how to act. So of course they lunged. They wasn't really fighting drama, but when they lunged at them, they all fell down on the floor, right? So it's like drama on the floor too. So all I see is day one swinging, I see another boy swinging, Red on the ground, he's swinging, I ain't gonna lie, he's swinging, but like, of course he's outnumbered. So drama is trying to, like, he like, bro, come on, he like, he's trying to break it up, but he trying to get up at the same time. That drama got his glasses, you know, we don't be playing about our buffs in the city. He got his glasses and stuff on, so when he fell, they flew off. So I ain't gonna lie, I guess his first instinct was to look for those and pick them up. I see him pick it up, so he walked back to the booth and he like, here, hold this. So he handed me his glasses and his phone. Now the phone was unlocked. Now I know some fighting going on, but I'm about to go through this phone. Even though this is not my nigga, it's just like, you can't even help the urge. Sometimes even when somebody is not your boyfriend, it's the temptation. And he gave me his phone unlocked, and I'm just sitting here like, let me go through these messages real quick. Let me see what's going on in here. You know, so no, I'm just slam. But he gave me his stuff, so he's trying to break it up. Of course, at this point, all the securities is there. But you know, when everybody is piled up on top of each other, it's kind of hard to even see what the fuck is going on. I don't even know. They trying to separate everything. So I see day one, his glasses and flew up. I'm picking shit up off the floor that I know belongs to somebody in our group. Because mind y'all, we're at a bar or a lounge or whatever we at. So when the fight broke out, people are getting pushed and other people are falling, because it's like when they jumped. It's people around us, y'all. It ain't like we just in this bitch by ourselves. So people was getting like, you know, people screaming and running and trying to dodge and get out the way. So stuff is falling. So I'm picking up stuff or whatever. The fight, of course, didn't, I don't even really call it a fight. It didn't last too long because of Chris's security here. They not about to just sit there and let them fight. They getting to break it. They trying to break it up or whatever. They pushing Red out the door. Day one don't want to let it go. You know, when a fight get broken up, you normally like, yeah, get that nigga out of here. He like, y'all, let's take it outside. Let's take it outside. He want to fight him outside, like, and want to square up because he's mad. Because he like, why would you think you was about to attempt to hit me with a bottle? What the fuck is you on? So he's trying to take it outside. So it's like, now that all the crowd is moving outside, I'm going outside too. Like, I was going to stay in my business. But if all of y'all are going outside, including everybody that's in our booth and drama, I'm definitely about to go outside too, right? So everybody is like going outside. Not everybody as far as everybody in the club, like bar, lounge, whatever. Some of them is staying, but the majority of like our people, whatever, they're going outside. So, you know, we get our stuff, we go outside too. Drama, of course, trying to break it up, like, day one, like, I got you, bro, like, for me, please, like, I'ma just take him home. He like, nah, this nigga try to hit me with a bottle, like, I don't play that shit, like, I don't play that. So, you know, Red still talking shit, because it's like, the security trying to walk him out, and they asking Drama, like, where his car at so we could put him in the car to send him on his way. But Drama like, he rolled with me. Drama trying to calm him down, but I'm like, Drama, you need to go get in the car so they can put Red in the car and keep it moving. Like, you over here trying to talk to Day One. Day One gonna be okay. Like, get him out of here. Get Red up out of there. So Red is like trying to dodge the security because it was only one security on him because they was like walking him away from everything. He trying to dodge and come back. So like, it's like they trying to still separate them or whatever. Now you got Day One and his friends, which is technically Drama friends. They like, that nigga run up over here, you already know, Drama, you already know. So I'm sitting here looking like, see, Drama, I told you not to bring this nigga. I'm like, Drama, go get in the car so they could put Red in the car. The longer you stay out here trying to talk to Day One, the longer Red is gonna have to be out here and is gonna keep up the drama. Go get in the car. So basically, like I said, they kind of walked them down the street a little bit, but the cars is parked back here. So I told Drama dumb stuff. I'm like, because they walked them down the street, I'm like, get in the car and pull up down the street to go get him. He telling Red to come back down here to get in the car because they gotta go this way. Nigga, it don't matter which way y'all going. Go that way and pick him up and do a U-turn and come back this way. So he telling Red to come down. Red come back down. Of course, not Day One, but somebody from his side run up on Red. Like, kind of like from the side. Not really the back, but it wasn't head on. He run up on Red, whatever. He hit him, whatever. So they kind of tussling a little bit. So I'm like, oh my God, get this nigga up out of here. Security break it up again. At that point, they pick up Red. It's two security guards. They walking him down to Drama car. So the whole time, Red is talking shit like, fuck y'all niggas, fuck y'all. Mind you, we standing out there. But he starts spitting. This goofy started spitting. He like, fuck y'all niggas, fuck y'all. But he spitting as he walking. And of course, I'm on that side. So I'm like, Drama, get his ass. Because he's spitting at everybody. And I'm backing up. But I'm like, bro, if that spit would have got on me, like, why is you spitting? So the security is getting mad too. Because he's just spitting it out. And they're holding him. Like, they got him, like, kind of in the air a little bit to take him to the car. So they like, bro, so you better stop spitting. Because I'm going to knock your ass out. Like, they saying stuff to him. Because I'm like, why the fuck would you be spitting, bro? Like, you're doing too much. You a grown ass man. Don't be spitting at people. But anyways, they finally put him in a car. So Drama gets to pulling off. So they pull off or whatever, and he take him wherever. So I'm with Day One. So I'm like giving him, like, it was a chain and stuff. So I'm like, here, Day One, your chain stuff off. So he like, thanks, K, whatever. I'm like, y'all good? He like, yeah, man, that nigga crazy. Like, I don't like him. Like, I be telling Drama that I don't fuck with him. I'm like, literally, me too. I literally told Drama that I did not want to hang with him and I didn't care for him because he do too much. So he like, yeah, he always doing too much. When he get to drinking, I don't, you know, he like, you know me. I don't like all that rah-rah. I don't like all that extra shit. He always do that. I'm like, yeah, I tried to tell Drama that nigga don't listen to me or whatever. So we end up going back into the club or whatever. And like I said, they know them. So that's why they were able to go back to the little club, bar, lounge, whatever, because they know them. So we go back in the club, whatever. That's when I realized I got Drama phone. So, you know, we try to keep turning up, but it's just like, it's so messy. Like, it's Red Bull everywhere. It's water everywhere. It's just too much going on. So, like, and at that point, they wanted to clean it up because some, it's like, stuff is broke. They try, it was already close to closing. So they like, y'all just gotta go, whatever. So, mind you, Drama is gone. We can't call him. So I was telling day one, like, can we just ride with you? So, you know, of course, he like, yeah, of course, like, that's fine. I'm like, and I got drama phone, so I can't even call him. So I'm like, just take us to drama house so I can get, you know, in my car and, you know, I have to see him another time, whatever. So he said, cool. So when we pulled up to drama house, his car wasn't there. He wasn't there. So I just put his phone and his glasses in his mailbox. And I'm like, hopefully he looked there. If not, hopefully he called me off somebody else's phone and I could let him know it's in there, because this is just too much. So I put his shit in there and I get in my car and me and my homegirls, we leave. We go home because, baby, I tried to tell you that I didn't want to be around that man, and it's always something with him. Well, I can't say it's always something with Red because I only been around him one time, but his vibe, like, I'm a good judge of character, and his vibe, his energy, I don't like that. I don't like him. I don't care for him. It was already weird the first day, but like I said, I try to give it because he just got out of jail, you know, so I was like, okay, I'm gonna give you some grace, but I don't like him and I don't want to be around him. And at this point, drama, you shouldn't either, because none of your friends care for him either. So hang out with him by yourself on your own time, okay? But yes, y'all, that is the end of my story time. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. Make sure you thumbs up this video and comment down below and make sure you are subscribed. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok at Kayshawn with 3 E's once again. But y'all already know, until next time, I'll see you in my next video. Peace.